I open by saying shame. Shame, 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 shame on you, New York. Look what your complacency has wrought! Hormone-deficient Midwesterners with Kmart haircuts walk your night streets with impunity! Remember the good old days of fear? Fear that kept you honest, New York! Healthy fear! Where's your tough guy pride now? When these emaciated, bearded hipsters lank about in neighborhoods where once hip-hop ruled! Yes! And now, organics. It used to be that the deviant subcultures of the world would come to New York to find each other. You'd feel alone in the world, and you would take that risk and come to this city to find people who were like-minded. Those were the people that built this city, the freaks, the weirdos. Where are they now? Online. Online! With the Grindr and the Scruff and the Tinder. Once upon a time, if you wanted anonymous sex in this city, you had to approach a stranger who might kill you. And the sex was better for it. But now, who creates art in this city now? Where the average rent in Manhattan is $4,000, can you make socially challenging art when you have to later earn $4,000 for rent? No, you learn how to eat that Koch brothers' penis, and with gusto. Or they put you back on your discount Chinatown bus, back to who gives a fuck. Once upon a time, the freaks had their place. Now we can't afford it. All that remains is dull, soulless, needle-dipped ambition. Alex Edelman.
Yes, queen!
Yes, queen! These children who overpay for vintage clothing so that they can look sharp at their unpaid internships. Cartoon graffiti by MFA students who paid $75,000 a year to write in bubble letters. Taylor Swift is your goddamn welcome ambassador. Taylor fucking Swift! She owns a mansion in Rhode Island and she's your face. Who are you anymore, New York? I used to know you. You know, once upon a time, there were real pimps and real hustlers on these goddamn streets, you know? And now, you have, like, these horrible, moneyed white people who think they have street cred because they went to a pimps and hoes party in college. No more! Drive them out of town! Boats, hustlers, booze, oh. I have this quote from a New York Magazine article. It said, in 1981, in an incident that attracted international attention and spurred a citywide existential crisis, a 26-year-old man from Connecticut was set upon, stripped naked, and chased by a jeering, bottle-throwing crowd in Times Square at night. Shadowy figures, drug peddlers, con artists, vagrants, as the Times would later describe the area's inhabitants, into a subway station, then onto the tracks where he died. Yeah. And good riddance! Listen!